This problem says in D4, which is the group of symmetries of a square under function composition being the operation, that consists of four rotations, the one of this, which R0 is just the identity rotation, rotate by 0 degrees, in other words, don't do anything, and four reflections, reflection across a vertical axis of symmetry, that's V, reflect this way, reflection across a horizontal axis of symmetry, that's H, flip this way. D is across the main diagonal axis of symmetry, like that. And D prime is the off diagonal axis of symmetry, flip like that. D4 has 8 elements in it. It is a group of order 8. It's a non-abelian group of order 8. I would actually like to solve these equations for the unknowns x, actually by brute force, but not because I like brute force, but because it's going to illustrate something else that is important to realize. You can think of these expressions on the left-hand side as being functions, if you like, functions of a variable x. You can define two functions here. This is the conceptual point. From D4 to itself, call it f and g. So I'm using arrow notation for my functions here. F is a function whose domain is D4 and whose codomain is D4. G is a function whose domain is D4 and whose codomain is D4. I'm going to define these functions by certain formulas. F of x equals x squared, and g of x equals x cubed. I can do that. I can define functions seemingly like you're used to from calculus in group theory. It's understood that when you square, when you cube, it's the group operation, though. It's not ordinary multiplication in this context. It's function composition. I'm not literally multiplying the functions, I'm composing them. But in group theory, it's a group theoretic kind of multiplication. And what, I mean, I'm treating these as functions. Can I graph them? Can I graph these functions? Well, it depends on what you mean by a graph, but I certainly could make a table of values for both of them. Make a table, one column labeled X, all the possible functions in D4, R0, R90, R180, R270. So these are rotations, counterclockwise rotations of a square by those different degrees. There's V, there's H, there's D, and there's D prime. What are the function values of F of X equals X squared? I got to square each of these things. Let's try to do it without looking at the Cayley table. Let's just try to think about it. R0, the do nothing rotation, when you square it, you still do nothing. If you do nothing twice, then you've done nothing overall. Actually, yeah, R0 to any power will be itself. R90, when you square it, rotate by 90 degrees, then another 90, that's R180. When you cube it, guess I'm doing both functions at once here, do a 90, that rotation three times, you've done a 270 degree rotation counterclockwise. R180, when you square it, 180 degree rotation, followed by another 180 degree rotation, gets you back to where you started. It's equivalent to a zero rotation, that's R0. When you cube it, it's effectively itself. Doing 180 degree rotation three times, the net effect is the same as just one 180 degree rotation. R270, rotating counterclockwise by 270 degrees once and then again, is equivalent to 180 degrees. And doing it one more time, 270 degrees, brings you back to something equivalent to 90 degree rotation. V, when you square it, flip about the vertical axis of symmetry, square it, you apply it twice, you get back to where you started. In fact, any flip when squared brings you back to where you started. equivalent to the do nothing rotation. When you cube it, v cubed is v squared times v is r zero times v is just v. You cube any flip, it's the same as the flip itself. So yes, this is brute force, but it's brute force with kind of an interesting point. You can define functions, you can make tables of values. Yeah, can you graph these? Yeah, you sort of could. You could you could sort of like make a graph where you have R0, R90, et cetera, down that axis, and R0, R90 up this axis, and plot individual points. Is that very informative? I don't know. You certainly wouldn't want to connect the dots. It's not a continuous function. These are finite sets. This can help you solve the problem now. What are all the x's whose cube is v? Look for the v in this column. It's just v itself. The solution set here is just v itself. What are all the elements whose cube is R90? R90 appears right there in the cube column. R270 is the only solution. Solution set is R270. Whose cube is R0? Only R0. The solution set is just R0. Whose square is R0? There's more than one solution to that, right? The solution set, there's lots of R0s in the square column corresponding to R0 and then all the flips. The solution set contains 5 elements. Oops. And finally, the solution of that one, anything whose square is H? No, nothing in the square column is an H. So this is the empty set. Oops, did I make a mistake? Question? Oh, I missed it. Yeah, R180, thank you. Okay. So yes, you can solve equations in group theory. And that's sometimes worthwhile to do. All right, have a good day.